Today we are going to see the third application of dimension and formula. In the last classes, you have seen two applications. Now this is our third application, that is to convert from one system of unit to another. We are familiar with the different systems of units like SI system, then CGS, MKS, like that. So some physical quantities we may have to convert from one system to another. Here we will see how can we convert a system of unit to another. Okay, so for simplicity we will take the example of energy. Energy is a physical quantity. First we will know what is the dimension formula of energy. Energy, work, all these have a dimension formula same, that is ml square t raised to minus 2. So the energy is a physical quantity. Then we can express energy, the quantity, physical quantity, we can express in two systems like this. N1, U1 in one system. Let us choose this to be SI system. This is an SI system. Let us convert to CGS. Let this be CGS system. N1 is the number of that particular quantity indicating the SI system. And N2 is the number in CGS system. We need to find out the value of N2. N1 we choose 1. So for simplicity, we choose N1 to be 1. So we can choose N1 to be 1. U1 is the unit in SI system. That we know that energy has a unit in SI system, joule. So what we can say, U1 is equal to joule. U1 is equal to joule. N2, that we don't know, that we need to calculate. U2 means the unit of energy in CGS system is erg. So we can write it as U2 is equal to erg. We need to find out how many ergs are, joule, that you have to find out. Okay, that's our aim. So we know N1, you know U1, U2 and N2. Now, how will you find out the conversion formula? So we have N1, N2. N1 is 1, N2 that we need to find out. U1 is in SI system. And U2 is the same quantity in CGS system. Okay. So equation is N1 U1 is equal to N2 U2. So what we'll do, we'll start with the equation. We have N1 U1 is equal to N2 U2. N1 we choose 1 into. Then U1. U1 is the physical quantity, unit of physical quantity energy, that we'll express in the form of dimension formula. So U1 will give dimension formula. It is subscript is 1. So we'll give M1. Then L1 raised to 2, it is given L1 because in first system, then T1 raised to minus 2 that we have written. It should be equal to N2 that we have to find out. N2 into U2, it is in another system, same quantity in another system. So we can get another subscript, that is M2, L2 raised to 2 and T2 raised to minus 2. Dimension formula is not changing, but we are just changing the symbols M1, M2, L1, L2 like that. We need to find N2. So from this, what is equation? We need to find N2. What is N2 from this equation? N2 is equal to N2 we need. We need to divide this by this. So we'll write M1, L1 raised to 2, T1 raised to minus 2 divided by M2, L2 raised to 2, T2 raised to minus 2. Okay, now we'll group together M1 and M2 together, L1 and L2 together, T1 T2 also together. So we'll write here M1 by M2. We need to find N2. So M1 by M2, the power is 1 raised to 1. L1 by L2 raised to 2 we can write. So L1 by L2 we have raised to 2. The power is 2. T1 by T2, the power is minus 2. So we will write T1 by T2 raised to minus 2. Okay. So now what we are going to do is, we will substitute M1 and M2. That is, we will take a unit quantity, unit mass we will take. Unit mass in SI system we can express as 1 kilogram. Kilogram is S unit of mass. In CGS it will be gram. So unit mass we will express in SI 1 kilogram. Correspondingly here it will be 1 gram. So we will express unit mass. Similarly, unit length and unit time we will express. So M1, instead of M1 what I'll write 1 kilogram, it is a unit to mass. In CGS, because second one U2 is CGS, in CGS what is the unit mass? 1 gram. It is raised to 1. Now length, in SI length has a unit, SI unit meter, so I will write 1 meter. Then here what I can write? I can write in CGS it is 1 centimeter. Okay, 1 meter and 1 centimeter. Then both systems in SI and CGS, the unit of time is second. So I'll write 1 second, T1, T2 also 1 second. So it is raised to minus 2. Here it is raised to 2. It is raised to minus 2. Okay. Now we know that 1 kilogram is 1000 gram. We'll write here 1000 gram divided by 1 gram. Then here we have 1 meter means 100 centimeter. We'll convert 100 centimeter by 1 centimeter raised to 2. 1 second by 1 second, nothing to convert. 1 by 1 is equal to 1. So we can get 1 raised to minus 2. 1 second cancelled with the 1 second. It is 1 raised to minus 2. Again, we will simplify. We'll cut gram. It is 1000. 1000 raised to 1. 1000 raised to 1 is 1000. I can write it as 10 raised to 3. 4000. 1000 is 10 raised to 3. Now, centimeter I cancel. 100 raised to 2. 10 raised to 2 raised to means 10 raised to 4. 100 raised to 2 means 10 raised to 4. 1 raised to minus 2 means 1 itself. It is 1. So what will you get? 10 raised to 7. So you have got N2 is equal to 10 raised to 7. N2 is now value in CGS. N1, 1 is the value in what? SI. In SI we have joule. CGS we have erg. So what we can write? N1 U1. N1 means 1 joule. U1 is joule. I can write 1 joule is equal to how many erg? N2 is equal to 10 raised to 7. I can write 10 raised to 7. Unit con second quantity is erg. Unit is erg. So this is a relation connecting joule to erg. So 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to 7 erg. So in this manner, we can convert from one system to another with the help of dimension formula, provided we have to know the dimension formula of that particular physical quantity. And we have to know the name of those quantities, name of those units of those quantities in both systems, in SI as well as CGS. So in this manner, we are converted from the SI to CGS unit of what? Energy. That is 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to 7 erg. Okay. So this is the third application, that is to convert from one system of unit to another. Okay. Thank you.